the bay at San Diego. This is kind of far.
Hey, on the flight deck, we'll be manning the rails on the flight deck, not the catwalks, on the flight deck.
And as you can see, it's early morning, heavy smog. We're still a ways out. We're out by the islands, out by a few small islands before you go into the bay. The bridge will be coming up real soon, they said. This is where the lighthouse is. I thought it was an island a while ago, and they told me it's where the lighthouse is. Drive out there from San Diego. We're going right into that area there. There's a bridge there. We make a wide turn and go under. Can't see it very good yet because of the smog. How they do it when they all stand out around the front of the ship, around the sides. Really looks nice. I don't know if the film will show it as good as it looks when you're here. And then you go around to the other side here, and they're standing all along over there too. And of course, then you get to the place they steer the old thing at. Everybody's excited, trying to get everything done. Here with girls hollering at him already. Poor Sean, he's down in the kitchen working. He'll have to work down there till 2 o'clock this afternoon. He pulled some bad detail. So, he didn't get in on it, but that's the way it goes. Can't be helped. Boat out there with, I think, girls on it, and it says welcome home. Needless to say, the guys enjoy that quite a bit. It's that same lighthouse, but now it's getting a little clearer out. It is real pretty. Like I say, everything is pretty except for the smog. Sometimes I kind of wonder how they can even make it. But, you know, that's how it is when you live in a certain area. I'm sure they're all used to it now. Get a little closer look at that lighthouse. There's the time of the day, so that we know where we're at. Thank you. lift out.
I'll hand it.
Thank you.
engine aboard. Hand salute.
Thank you. first plane is superior to the boy.
going inside Belgrade a lot more. Is there a pattern to those?
I think there's a pattern which is trying to do everything we can whilst trying also to minimize civilian casualties, because we are trying to minimize those civilian casualties. We're trying to do everything we can direct the apparatus of power that he has unleashed upon these Kosovar Albanian people. And, you know, these are people who...
went out in the army here, and they're calling us from there wanting to know where the officers are. that it's been very, very close. And that perception would have an effect on people's travel plans.
For Chris Gertovich, the decision to change her plans was a difficult one.
You know, it's better to lose a few $100 and not take any risks. And it's really sad because we were, you know, really looking forward to it. It's going to be a big sort of a family reunion. And now we don't know when it'll happen, if it will happen.
In the meantime, European travel officials will fight the adage that perception is often reality, to prevent tourism from becoming another casualty of this international conflict. Cruising may be the part of the travel industry hardest hit by the conflict in the Balkans. Every major cruise line has canceled trips or changed itineraries due to the war. The good news, most cruise lines were...
Just about done. Should get some.